shot. Nicely done. Let me truss this one up and I'll make my way over to you.
There you are. Any new revelations? So you met with that gleaner again, this time to capture a hornbill. I understand catching and bringing in creatures from the outside, but what's the point of chasing after ones already here?
Oh, it's a simple thing, really. Occasionally, we remove specimens no longer needed for study, or those we've had difficulty raising. But we can't simply turn them loose. Safely returning such creatures to their native habitats is another facet of a gleaner's duties. But not in this case, I'm afraid. I've been asked to bring the bird below.
The restricted section in the lower levels of Labyrinthos. Open only to a select few researchers hand-picked by the Forum. The projects down there are the subject of rumor and hearsay. Forbidden magics. Advanced technologies that can never be allowed to fall into outside hands. Even Archons are not privy to the truth. Those who are, the researchers involved in this secretive work, are not permitted to walk freely in the city, and are instead required to live in isolated quarters.
What could a facility subject to such strict security protocols possibly need with a hornbill? An experiment?
Possibly. I wasn't afforded an explanation. But judging by the requisition list given to me and my colleagues, I doubt it's for any kind of advanced research. I'd be more inclined to believe we were making preparations to migrate to the south. Meresidia or thereabouts.
What? Why would you say that?
Much of the flora and fauna we were asked to procure could serve as reliable sources of sustenance. They're comparatively hardy species, too, able to endure harsh climates. And among them are specimens known to be effective in improving soil quality and purifying water.
When you put it that way, migration does sound like a reasonable assumption.
That's all it is, though. An assumption. Through our tasks, we gleaners glimpse only bits and pieces of the Forum's plans. Our prime concern is that our requisitions, be they living or otherwise, are properly preserved for the knowledge of future generations. Now, I really must be going. I regret that I cannot reward you as you deserve.
Perhaps you might reward us after a fashion, then. It is imperative that we reach the lower levels. And seeing as you are already set to descend with your assigned cargo, mayhap we could accompany you as your assistants.
I'm afraid that won't be possible. Once the animals have been prepared for transport, we send them down separately via the lift. I will, of course, follow after to make my report, but I can hardly pass you off as porters when there's nothing left to carry.
Indeed. Pray, forget I said anything.
How do you feel about climbing? If you've strength and the courage to brave it, then there is another way down. This path leads to the 33rd facet, a mineshaft excavated during one of our expansions of Labyrinthos. While I cannot guarantee that the passage is safe to traverse, it should provide access to the medial circuit below.
I never even knew such a place existed. Thank you. This is the perfect solution.
You're quite welcome. But consider yourselves warned. If the going proves too treacherous, you'd do well to turn back. I bid you good day.
Well, turning back is hardly an option, not when we've come this far. Let's go and take a look at this mineshaft.
Thank you. Hard to look away, isn't it? But they're more than pretty flowers. Heart blooms are attuned to ambient emotion. You don't seem convinced, but believe me, it's true. This ashen grey, for instance, it mirrors the anxiety and urgency of those working nearby as they rush to fulfill sudden orders. Intense feelings like those spur the petals to change colour. Bright glowing hues in the presence of joy. Dark, subdued shades for frustration or despair. Yet even with the collected wisdom of Charlian at our disposal, we've yet to identify the underlying principle of this empathic effect. And there are other mysteries besides. Although the flower is extraordinarily long-lived, its low reproductive rate has made it difficult to find younger populations growing in the wild. With too few sightings to map its distribution, and no closely related species to track, we've been unable to pinpoint its land of origin. To further complicate matters, every culture, even dimly aware of its existence, has given it a different name and mythos. Our attempts to study it via the historical record have been an exercise in frustration. As an avid botanist myself, I should one day like to unravel the heartbloom's secrets. But I'm afraid other duties must take precedence. I will leave you to your thoughts.
Have you learned aught of interest? A flower that reacts to one's feelings? Strange. I must say, I have never heard of such a thing.
This is all very fascinating. But as it stands, we fail to gain any significant insight into the Forum's undertaking.
Indeed. While there is certainly enough activity to support Erenville's supposition that a priority has been placed on improving food production, unfortunately for our investigation, these workers were never informed as to how their duties serve the master plan.
If only we could interrogate the Forum members directly. Isn't that the entrance to the Archaeum? Look, there. I think that's Erenville.
A little difficult to tell from here, but I think you're right. He did say he was coming down to make his report.
Erenville receives his orders from the Forum. Would it not follow, then, that the superior to whom he reports is a Forum member, or at least a close associate?
You mean to eavesdrop on their conversation? What of the risks?
Ours alone to bear. We won't interfere with Erenville's work, nor will he be implicated as an accomplice. If you're not comfortable taking part, I can do this alone.
Nay. I said myself that I wished to know Father's intentions, And no answers will be forthcoming should we simply ask nicely.
We can apologize later, should it come to it. Right now, we need every crumb of information we can get our hands on. Consequences be damned.
It might be best if you came along as well. In fact, we should all... Cryle?
Oh, yes, that certainly sounds like a plan.
I'm glad you agree.
Quickly, Erenville is on the move. We need to get closer before we lose him.
Almost. I can almost reach you.